Oh, this is Jim Cornette, and tonight we're in Baton Rouge, Louisiana, the home of Jimmy Swaggart, and he's watching tonight. We're just not sure what, but you're going to see three main event matches. Captain Mike Rotunda taking on Shane Douglas. You're also going to see Eddie Hot Stuff Gilbert against the great Muta with Gary Hart, and our main event today, Road Warrior Hawk going up against Samu the Samoan in a captain's match in that war between the Road Warriors and the Samoan SWAT team right here, right now on the Power Hour. Ladies and gentlemen, and yes, we are in the Centerplex in Baton Rouge, Louisiana, on this special Saturday night edition of the NWA Power Hour. And of course, it's time for Jim to tell us a program note, special programming note tonight on one of the other networks on Soul Train. Don Cornelius' special guest is Teddy Peanut Headlong, who becomes the first person in history to be stumped by the Soul Train Scramble. But if you want to watch the Power Hour, we got a lot of stuff. Funk's Grill tonight has the Steiner Brothers. That ought to be real interesting. Gordon with the news. Everything's going on. A new night for the Power Hour here this week. And golly, we're just...
I dropped by the university here that Jimmy Swaggart's the president of, owner, president, and he said to wish you his condolences, but you're a little slow on the donations here lately.
Well, I saw Jim. I flipped a couple of pennies out my window last night. I thought he'd catch them, but I forgot I had my shades closed for once.
I thought I saw him on Airline Highway down in New Orleans, but it must have been somebody else in the Lincoln.
Was he wearing a jogging suit? We better get to the matches before we get kicked off the air, fans, and we're going to go to that match right now, right here.
Ladies and gentlemen, our first match on this special edition of the NWA Power Hour. Will you welcome from the City of Sunshine, representing the Dynamic Dudes, this is Shane! His opponent represents the Orange Man of Syracuse University, Captain Mike Rotunda.
Hey. Shane, you don't know how sorry I am that your partner got his face smashed. You know what I mean? But, I'll tell you what I'm gonna do. Because I'm such a good sportsman, this is what I'm gonna do. And referee, I agreed with you earlier that if you catch me throwing an illegal blow in this match, that I will give Shane Douglas my most prized possession, my letter jacket from Syracuse. Something that he could never earn himself, but I will give it to him if you catch me throwing an illegal blow.
I know that must overwhelm Shane to be able to have the opportunity to win a Syracuse letter jacket. You can hear what the fans here in Baton Rouge, Louisiana, think about Syracuse. If it would have been an LSU letter jacket, I'm sure there would have been a roar gone up, but not for Syracuse and the Orange Men, even though it's a phenomenal institution, great athletic program. I often wonder how the university thinks of Mike Rotunda representing the Orange Men in the method that he does. So he has made a pact. He's made an agreement that if he's caught in breaking any rules, he will forfeit the match and his prize possession, his Syracuse letter jacket. Takeover, one. Rotunda rolling Shane right back over on his shoulders. Does it one more time. Shane's got a great amateur background as well, perhaps not as lofty as wrestling for Syracuse, but he's certainly very well versed in Greco-Roman and catch-as-catch-can amateur wrestling. Well, Rotunda was complaining that Shane broke the rules there. Certainly no validity in that statement. Side headlock by Mike Rotunda, once again legally taking over Shane. And Shane counters with a head scissors very, very quickly. Rotunda has a cheap way of breaking the maneuver. Effective, it works, but not something you would think an outstanding collegiate athlete would do on this occasion. Collar and elbow, and Rotunda. That was a legal open hand. He didn't clench his fist, and he really nailed him with that chop. Rotunda, I think, more than anything, he started it off trying to get inside this youngster's head, talking about his partner, Johnny. In a recent event involving the dudes and the New Zealand militia, sustained a broken cheekbone. Near a fall there, Shane rolled over on his shoulders. Rotunda holding him legally, but cannot hold him down as Shane rolls back on to the advantage here with a side headlock. Still to come, Hot Stuff Eddie Gilbert and the Great Muta, plus Road Warrior Hawk and Samu of the Samoan SWAT team. Very rare occasion to see the Road Warriors in single competition, or the SST for that matter, but it is a captain's match later on in this special edition of the NWA Wrestling Power Hour there on TBS, the Superstation. Once again, Rotunda with that open hand chop, trying to create an environment that Shane will lose his composure. Ball tackle by the former DT. Defensive tackle, Syracuse, good drop toe by Shane, who clearly thus far in this contest has proven that he is the quicker of the two men. Shane, nice move, taking the legs out of Mike Rotunda, putting Rotunda on his back and getting the strength advantage. Shane now working on the leg. Twisting the ankle against the grain. James, look at Shane's, for a moment there, he had his right foot holding Rotunda down. Trying to cross face Shane. Relieves some of the pressure, and Shane works on the leg of Mike Rotunda, but that was a legal blow, and Shane, I think, has been seething since Rotunda's facetious and derogatory remarks about Shane's partner, Johnny, sustained that broken cheekbone recently at the hands of the New Zealand militia. Johnny will be out of action for several weeks, I understand. And Shane, I understand, will also be trying to help his partner train and get it back together. Nice go behind, waist lock there by Mike Rotunda, but the quickness of Shane coming to the front as he sets out, right back quickly up to his feet. Rotunda really prides himself that he is has the greatest amateur background of any athlete in the sport. His scientific challenge to Dr. S.D. Williams is making headlines around the mat world. The NWA has a lot of gifted athletes with college backgrounds, including the Steiners, and of course Dr. Death and Rotunda. Big chop again by Rotunda. It's a legal blow. European-like forearm maneuver. Reminiscent of Dory Funk Jr. And those real stinging uppercut forearm blows. And Rotunda, I think, has the better of this match as far as the mind games, because look at the expression on Shane's face. He's one of the most even-tempered young men that I have had the privilege of being around, but Mike Rotunda is provoking this young man to deviate from his game plan, not think about wrestling, but think about fighting or destroying Rotunda, thus giving Rotunda the opportunity to out-wrestle the youngster. Eddie Gilbert and the great Muta. Several weeks ago, it was a great Muta that sprayed Missy Hyatt in the face. Eddie Gilbert was at ringside when Sting and Muta had their confrontation at Glory Days. The situation will be settled with a no disqualification match. High cross body, one, two, and Tommy Young got two out of it. A near fall, and Rotunda had his fist doubled up. I think Rotunda is just on the verge of losing his composure somewhat, getting a little frustrated that Shane is outquicking him and has been in the past several moments. This phenomenal crowd here in Baton Rouge, Louisiana, solidly behind the youngster from the City of Sunshine. Tommy Young going between there. And that's Rotunda with a thumb right to the eye. And he's denying that he did it. The fans saw it. We saw it, but the ref did not, unfortunately. Snapping him out with snap hair, dropping the elbow on it. So it was Rotunda who was the first man to break the rules. Lateral press, he had the leg grapevine, but could not hold Shane down. I think you would call a blatant thumb to the eye an infraction of the rules. Reverse chinlock by Captain Mike Rotunda.
All right, Mike. Hit him out, Rick. Hit him out.
What a shot. And Shane has had just about enough of it. And Shane now calling Rotunda outside the ring. He may be making a mistake right here. Rotunda caught him coming in. Shane's emotion perhaps getting the best of him here as Rotunda caught him with a clothesline right in the face. And look at the smile on Mike Rotunda. Rotunda front face kicking into the snap suplex. Taking Shane over, one, two, but he could not hold him down. He's got the youngster frustrated and in trouble. Good reversal by Shane. Elevating Captain Mike. Up in the lights here on the Power Hour. What a way to kick off this special edition here on the Superstation with these two superb athletes. And now it's all Shane of the Dude.
Whoa, be careful. You all right?
I thought that Rotunda elevated him there a little over that top rope from my vantage point. Rotunda catching coming in. Inside cradle. Can he hold him down? One, two. Yes, he can.
The winner of the match, Captain Mike Rotunda.
I hope we can see this in replay where Rotunda, I think Rotunda, out of the referee's line of sight, just hoisted Shane over the top rope. He fell right on his back on the ring apron and then was inside cradle as he came back in. Well, we're going to take another look at it right here. This was after Rotunda boosted him over the top rope. The referee was not in a position to see it, unfortunately. And Rotunda holds him down on the inside cradle. And Mike Rotunda on a collision course with Dr. Death. And now we're on a course for James E. Cornette.